Shell, do you know, I didn't think you wasn't never going to see me no more again the other night. It's a fact. Well, you know my boy Norm? You know the one that drives the lorry with the big ears? Well, the other day was Norm's mum's birthday, see? So we all went over to the fun fair for a bit of a laugh. There was Norm, Norm's mum, and Norm's mum's lodger, Mr. Pilchard. He's the one that went on What's My Line and nobody guessed him. Well, when we get to the fun fair, Norm says that wild horses wouldn't drag him onto anything that goes round and round. Oh, because he can't do with it. Now he turns pale green and you have to be nice to him. But Mr. Pilchard says he don't mind coming round the twisted tower on a little mat, but he does draw the line at going on the giant wheel. And of course it's this giant wheel that Norm's mum's so dead keen to get on, see? I think it's funnier liking anything as daring as that, because she's on the nervy side, isn't she? Well, I mean, she don't fancy lighting the gas. And she can't come down a ladder once she's got up it. And she always feels funny after fish. But this giant wheel, she says, look, she says, it's my birthday and I am going on it willy or nilly. Well, I can't let her go alone, you see. So I says to Norm, look, you and Mr. Pilchard, you go over there somewhere. Go on, go and find yourselves a cup of tea and wait and see us come looming over the horizon in the giant wheel. Well, as we're going along to get on it, Norm's mum says to me, she says, you're going to enjoy it, you know. It's like you got wings on. Well, I says, we've all got to go in the end if our name's on it. Come on. Well, this attendant fella, you know, he says, room for a little one in here. And he puts Norm's mum in with a sailor. And he says, and room for you in here. And I get put in a seat with a teddy boy-like fella. You know, he's got his hair all cut long and curly up in the front, like. And he's sprawled all over the seat. So I say, good evening. And he says, hello. And I say, nice weather for the time of year. And he says, so what? Well, we fastens ourselves into the giant wheel. You know the giant wheel, don't you, Shirley? You know, it's that great, big, huge, enormous wheel you see sticking out of the top of fun fairs before you get there. It's got these little seats, like, that hang down. And when the wheel turns, you'd think those little seats was going to turn over. But they don't. No, they go on hanging down. Well, it's scientific. Well, we get started. And when we get up to the top, like, everybody gives a little scream because it makes you feel like you might go over. And I like a nice little scream, you know, when it's for pleasure. We done this, what, 2-3 times? And about the fourth time, when we get right up at the top, me and the teddy boy fella, the engine stops. It's gone wrong, see? Well, I look over the side and I can see Norm's mum down there. I says, are you all right? She says, I'm all right. You all right? I says, I'm all right. She says, I'm all right. I've got a sailor with his arm round me waist. She's always been keen on the Navy, you know, ever since she could remember. Well, my teddy boy just sits there, glazed. I says to him, you know, we're stuck up here. And he says, so what? I says, tar for the chat. Mind you don't wear yourself out with talking. Well, I sing to myself, you know, pass the time. I done, we'll gather lilacs. But he just sits there with his eyes shut, so I nudge him, see if he's dead. And he says, I don't like it up here. He says, I'm going to get out of it. So I says, go on, walk. Well, you'd have thought Norman, Mr. Pilchard would have noticed we hadn't come down by now. There's quite a little crowd gathered down there. And after a minute, I see Norm. I recognise him by his slightly prominent ears. So I give him a little yell. And he says, how did you get up there? I says, I got flew up on a broomstick. Well, he says, you don't half look silly. Why don't you fly down? So I says, look, Mr. Clever, if you're such a good motor mechanic, why don't you mend what's wrong, eh? Well, I see him hesitate. Then he speaks to somebody, takes his coat off, tampers with this and that, gets the engine started, and of course we come down, and he's the hero of the day. Oh, everyone says, well, he's the jolly good fella, and he turns red, and he says, it wasn't nothing, he said. All he'd done, he said, was get a bolting leech cleat off of a D-valve Swithin circuit. Oh, I says, fancy you being able to get a bolting leech cleat off of a D-valve Swithin circuit. Oh, I says, it wasn't difficult. He says, look, he says, I never meant it just now when I said you look silly. He says, you're all right. I says, so are you. He says, shut up. Oh, he is nice.